Hi! Do you need a static website that is super fast and performs best in Google search? In this video, I'm going to help you choose between Gatsby and Jekyll. Two popular static website generators. After this video, you'll know exactly which one to choose and why. Let me tell you about Maria and Dennis.
Maria is a coach. She helps people lose weight. She reached out to me because she wants to create a website for herself. She wants to publish articles and success stories of her clients. Her page would be an About Me page, contact page, and a list of blog posts. Simple tips and tricks and success stories. So super simple. And Dennis? Dennis is a web designer. He makes design for pages. He also does the HTML, CSS, and is familiar with React and Angular. He wants to redesign his page. Before, he had a simple HTML page, but now he wants to upgrade it to a simple shop where people can buy his design templates. He still wants his site to be static so it can load faster.
So which one would you use, Jekyll or Gatsby? So when and why would you use any of them?
Gatsby is the newest static site generator. It's powered by Node and it's growing quite fast. So why would we use Gatsby? First, the very good reason is that Gatsby generates progressive web apps. With Gatsby, your site enjoys the benefits that comes with them. Progressive web apps are websites that look and feel like an app. This means users can access all information and capabilities without downloading a mobile app. Gatsby supports GraphQL, and you can load your data from all sorts of data sources, like a database, an API, WordPress site, or a markdown file. And Gatsby has a lot of plugins. It also has a huge user community. The documentation is great, and you can find good tutorials and courses. Yes, sounds very good. So why would we not then just say to both Maria and Dennis, Gatsby is the way to go? Well, this. Using Gatsby has a steep learning curve. Knowledge of JavaScript, React, and GraphQL is needed. Gatsby JS involves a lot of configuration and setup. You're learning something completely new. You're not just writing JavaScript as you do in a React or Node.js app. You might find yourself saying, "This is so different than anything I have done before as a React developer." Don't get discouraged. For building website, it is the brains behind the static site generator.
Now let me tell you about Jekyll.
It was released in 2009, and Jekyll is the oldest static site generator on the list. It's written in Ruby and used worldwide. Thanks to its affiliation to GitHub, Jekyll has gained a lot of attention and contributors from the open source community. While Jekyll uses Markdown for page content, it also uses Liquid templating language to process pages. Jekyll uses CSS2, which is huge for developers who like CSS preprocessors.
What are the good parts of Jekyll?
Setting up and deploying Jekyll is a super simple process. It also has a huge developer community. You will find people to help you out. Tutorials are available and the documentation is okay. It uses the Liquid templating language, which is easy to learn. And Jekyll is great for search engine optimization. Also, there are tons of plugins available.
And why not use Jekyll?
Well, it is not a progressive web app. It is just a static site. And working with assets might be a hassle. Minimizing JavaScript and image preloading does not come out of the box for you. But it does use CSS. Also, setting up for Windows users might be difficult. Jekyll needs a Ruby environment.
Okay, before we make a decision, let's first check how Jekyll and Gatsby work behind the scenes.
With Gatsby, you can get data from anywhere. It could be a Markdown, API, database, or WordPress. And Jekyll uses Markdown and HTML pages. Gatsby is really a React app. It has components and so on, but it works much different. Gatsby is going to go ahead and make the page into a static HTML page beforehand. So Gatsby will fetch all the data at a compile time, that is before you deploy your website, or as a part of some deployment process. The pre-processed static pages will be immediately served up for you. The page is loaded, and then it loads the React part. Since the React part is the same as static page, you can see no difference after the React is loaded. But the page starts working as a dynamic page, meaning you can have dynamic content also. You can easily make hybrid apps. Apps that are partly static sites generated beforehand and partly dynamic pages that work as a React app, which is great for search engine optimization. Gatsby will preload content that you need for SEO, and a dynamic part like comments or gadgets will still work as a React app. Gatsby created pages still become a full React application. A great course on Udemy that will teach you how to get the best out of Gatsby is the course from Tom Phillips. Title is Gatsby JS and Firebase Build Hybrid Real-Time Static Sites. You will learn in depth how the Gatsby works behind the scenes, and you learn how to get the most out of plugins. Also, you will know how to add dynamic parts like commenting, registration.
I highly recommend this course. It has a high rating, and Tom responds promptly so you can develop fast. The biggest advantage of Jekyll is its simplicity. The learning curve is super fast.
I have a Udemy course that will speed up your blog development process. You'll have your blog set up and running in no time. In this course, we create a blog together, and I show you all about liquid templating. And liquid templating is all you need to know when creating a static site with Jekyll. So what do you think? What should Maria use? She wants to have her site up and running fast, and she does not want to learn React and GraphQL. But she has some knowledge of HTML, CSS, since she was making sites as a hobby. So what I recommend to her is to use Jekyll.
She took my course, and now she's super happy helping her clients lose weight.
Dennis was having second thoughts. He knows a little about development, so he heard from a friend that he could also use Node.js with React to create static websites. So we talked about that too. I will give you a link to the video where we discuss the difference between Gatsby and Next.js. Let me summarize what we have learned. So what is the difference? Both Jekyll and Gatsby are great for SEO, and they serve super fast static pages. Jekyll has a simple learning curve, while for Gatsby you need to know more. With Jekyll you only need to learn liquid templating and have a basic knowledge of the terminal. Jekyll's templating system is liquid, while Gatsby is a React app. But with Gatsby you need to learn React, GraphQL and all the configuration options it has. But your app will be a responsive web page with all its advantages, not only a static site. Both have a great communities and lots of support.
Gatsby is more like WordPress. It comes with a lot of plugins.
With a plugin, you can minimize images, compile JavaScript, minify it. So to learn Gatsby, I recommend Udemy course from Tom Phillips. Title is Gatsby JS and Firebase Build Hybrid Real-Time Plus Static Sites. And to learn Jekyll, I welcome you to my course. Both links are here below.
Now, if you're like Dennis and your app is not a simple block, and also have some knowledge of React and Node.js, then I welcome you to the next video where we'll help Dennis to decide whether to use Gatsby or Next. And you can decide too. See you there. I'd also like to invite you to subscribe to my channel. I will be publishing new content every week. So have a great day. Bye-bye.